Hey guys, and welcome back. Well, now only a few months have passed since Kobe Bryant died in a tragic helicopter crash. Now for his fans, there could be no sort of consolation. Back in April, Golden Auction House organized one of the largest Kobe memorabilia sale ever. Now, as much as 100 different items were put up for bidding, and a part of the proceeds was donated to charity. Now, when Kobe Bryant and the LA Lakers won the 1999 to 2000 NBA championship, the team awarded each of its players with a dazzling diamond ring. Now, furthermore, Kobe got two more identical rings made and gifted his parents with. Now, however, in 2013, Joe and Pamela Bryant sold their rings along with some more memorabilia for a sum of $280,000. Now, as stated by Golden Auctions in May, Pamela's ring alone sold for around $206,000. Now, the value has certainly increased over the years. A large part of it also relates to the fact that many faithful Laker fans would want to own something left behind by the Mamba. Now, by successfully auctioning of Pamela's ring, Golden has set a mammoth price to Joe Jelly Bean Bryant's ring, as reported by TMZ. Now, as per their sports website, the ring has 40 real diamonds embedded in it. Now, Golden Auction has told TMZ that they are expecting the ring to fetch them over $250,000. Now, while they are absolutely certain of the ring selling for such a massive price, there are more Kobe collectibles that you can get. Now, a cast worn and signed by Kobe Bryant is also in the listing. It is from 1999 when he broke his wrist during the preseason. Now, as for the price tag, $20,000 is the expected price for his cast. Now, a rookie Kobe Bryant trading card claimed to be extremely rare and is worth somewhere around $75,000. Now, moreover, a gem of a collection for any basketball fan is available within the auction house. Now, any NBA fan would love to own a basketball signed by Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, and LeBron James. Now, with several items auctioned off, these are some of the most rare items that you can find in collections. Now, the demand for such Kobe Bryant memorabilia is higher than ever. Fans and collectors would feel privileged to own something that Kobe carried along with him during his lifetime. Yes, well, you know, my take on this is I just don't understand, you know, why his parents, you know, I know this was done in 2013 and now they're auctioning that off. Auction people are auctioning off, not his parents, because they already auctioned it off. But I really, that part where, you know, they auctioned off his stuff and got that money, I would, if my son was in the NBA and gave me that ring, I wouldn't have auctioned it off. But, you know, I understand, I guess they needed money and Kobe wouldn't give him any. I don't think anyone understands that. I mean, you know, if you're not close to your parents, but they seem to have done everything for Kobe to make him a star, for him to be selfish enough to even sue them for auctioning off some of his, you know, he sued his mother for auctioning off some of his memorabilia. You know, I tell you, I will never understand that part, and I guess, you know, I never will, because I just can't see. If my parents needed money, I would have gave them money. I mean, I don't know. Well, maybe, you know, maybe Vanessa will buy them. I mean, she got the money. And, you know, save them for her daughters, you know, for them to have. Because, you know, stuff like that, I would think. Stuff like that, especially now that he's gone, I would want it in the family. Alright guys, what y'all think about that? Alright guys, thank you so much for watching my video. Hope that you will like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And as always, imparted, be blessed, y'all.